Good morning, my dear friends. How are you all? Welcome to this new session of Physics Today. And as you all know that in our last lecture, we were talking about the concept of a capacitor and how a parallel plate capacitor works. What is a parallel plate capacitor? This was the concept that we have done in our last lecture. Today, my dear friends, we will be continuing with the same concept and try to see how the introduction of a dielectric in a capacitor influences its capacitance or affect its capacitance. This is our article. We all know that if we have an air capacitor, yani a capacitor which is having only air or vacuum between the two plates of this capacitor, in that case, we have seen that the capacitance is given by epsilon naught A divided by D. This is the capacitance of a capacitor which is having the air in between the two plates, the plates which are separated by a distance d and have, you can say, area of cross section as a each. Now, in our last lecture, we have seen that if we introduce a dielectric in this capacitor, then the capacitance is looking something like this, epsilon naught A into K by D. But now this we will derive and understand in our article today, okay, how when we introduce a dielectric, the capacitance change. Now, first of all, my dear friends, you all know that a dielectric basically is a kind of a capacitor or even a conductor which usually behaves like an insulator, but when you introduce it in a field generated by some charge, then due to induction, it also starts developing the charge. So let us consider that if we have a parallel plate capacitor having the two plates A and B separated by a distance d and having the area of cross section as A and B, then you know, okay, if it is given a positive charge, then due to induction, there will be a negative charge on this face and the positive charge of the other face will be earthed. So this is the capacitor. Now due to this capacitor, there will be obviously a development of an electric field. So let us say that the electric field is E naught. It means E naught is the electric field in the air capacitor. E naught is the electric field in air capacitor. Is it clear, my dear friends? Now, suppose if I introduce a dielectric, suppose I introduce a dielectric slab inside the two, you can say between the two plates of the capacitor, such that this T is the thickness of the parallel dielectric, then you know by the concept of electric field, the electric field is inversely proportional to the dielectric K. It means when we introduce the dielectric, the electric field decreases. It means the moment we will introduce the dielectric of thickness T between these two plates, kya hoga? The electric field, which is E naught, will reduce, and let that reduced electric field is now E. What is E? E is now the electric field due to dielectric. Jaise hi dielectric aayega, to E. Now you can clearly see that this is the dielectric, my dear friends. What is the strength of electric field in the dielectric? E. देखो जैसे ही ये charges के बीच में dielectric आएगा, induction की वजह से dielectric will start producing electric field. यही तो कर concept है ना? एंड उसकी जो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ है वो हमने ई मान ली है. एंड व्हाट इज द थिकनेस ऑफ डाई इलेक्ट्रिक? दिस इज टी. एंड नाउ यू कैन वेरी वेल सी के इफ वी रिमूव दिस, इफ वी रिमूव दिस थिकनेस फ्रॉम द एंटायर थिकनेस और यू कैन से डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द प्लेट्स, यानी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया वेयर द डाई इलेक्ट्रिक इज नॉट देयर, द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी ई नॉट. इज इट क्लियर? ये बात तो ठीक है ना? इनसाइड द डाई इलेक्ट्रिक द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज ई, एंड वेयर देयर इज नो डाई इलेक्ट्रिक देयर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल रिमेन ई नॉट. And we know that the total potential due to this system will be given by the potential due to dielectric plus the potential, you can say, due to air capacitor. Is it clear? You know, whenever there is electric field, there is a potential difference. And we all know that this potential is given by the strength of the electric field, the strength of the electric field multiplied by the distance. So when we talk about the potential due to dielectric, the strength of the electric field is E and the thickness is T. This is V is equal to plus, when I talk about the electric field, it is shabash, E naught, very good. And what about the distance? Naturally, if this is total D and when I remove this T, what I will be left? That is very good. D minus T. So this is the potential. Now, my dear friends, we all know that as per the definition of dielectrics, the dielectric constant K is equal to the ratio of electric field to in air to the electric field when it is placed in a medium. So according to the concept, K is equal to E naught by E. So from here I can find the value of E. What is E going to be? Shabash. E will be equal to E naught divided by K. E naught divided by K. So what I can do? I can put this value of E from here in this equation, and when I do this, what will happen? You will just see here, as simple as that, V is equal to E naught by K. V is equal to E naught by K into T plus E naught into D minus T. Is it clear, beta? ठीक है ना? शाबाश. अब देखिए, we can take E naught as common, and what will be left inside? It will be D minus T plus T by K. This is what is left with us. जहां तक किसी को कोई डाउट, कोई क्लैरिफिकेशन, किसी ने कोई चीज पूछनी हो, ठीक है बेटा. अब हर बच्चे को पता है कि व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द पोटेंशियल, सॉरी कैपेसिटेंस. वी ऑल नो दैट द कैपेसिटेंस इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाई वी. कैपेसिटेंस इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाई वी. तो सी इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाई वी. And when I take this value, or you can say when I put this value, what I get? C is equal to Q over E naught into D minus T plus T by K. And what is E naught, my dear friends? E naught, sigma over epsilon naught, that is E naught is equal to. E naught is equal to sigma over epsilon naught. And what is sigma? Surface charge density. Surface charge density. And that is Q by V. That is Q by V or A. Q by A. So E naught is equal to Q by A and epsilon naught. Any doubt? So this value of E naught I can put here, and what I get? C is equal to Q over Q into D minus T plus T by K over A into epsilon naught, and I will take it up. A into epsilon naught. Is it clear? So this Q stands cancelled with Q, and that's all. So this is the value of the capacitance when I talk about the insertion of a dielectric slab of thickness T inside the capacitor. तो उसकी जो capacitance है, that is given by this particular formula. I hope this article is clear till this point. ठीक है बेटा? चलिए, ये हो गई है हमारी पार्शियल इंसर्शन ऑफ द डाई इलेक्ट्रिक. पार्शियल मतलब पूरे कैपेसिटर में हमने थोड़ा सा डाई इलेक्ट्रिक डाल दिया, तो But if we, this is the second case, okay, if we insert the dielectric wholly, if we insert the dielectric wholly, कहने का मतलब है कि अगर मैंने पूरा का पूरा इसके अंदर डाइलेक्ट्रिक भर दिया, इफ दिस इज माई एंटायर डाइलेक्ट्रिक, देन व्हाट विल हैपन? ऑब्वियसली ऑब्वियसली व्हाट विल हैपन इन दैट केस, योर टी विल बी इक्वल टू डी. तो इफ द डाइलेक्ट्रिक is filled wholly, यानी अगर completely कर देंगे, then what will happen? The thickness will change to the distance between the plates of the capacitor, and what will be your capacitance in that case? It will be epsilon naught A over D minus D plus d by k. This d, यानी हमने क्या किया, t की जगह in place of t I have put d. So finally what you will get, this k will go up, you will get epsilon naught a into k by d. It means when we add the capacitor, the dielectric in the capacitance, sorry, in the capacitor, the capacitance of it increases, because you can see that capacitance is directly proportional to the dielectric. I hope this article is clear to you, and next article we will continue in our next session. Till that time, take care of yourself. And God bless you, my dear. All the very best. Thank you.